Thanks for joining me here on Naturally Wired AP. We've got a lot of things coming up in the show, including some backstage footage from the Boston Music Awards that were held back in April. The band Three Believers, and the band we're about to see right now has been from Holy Cross College. Ephesus has been playing in the Worcester Area Club for the better part of 2 years. Current band members are John Calabro, Dan Slattery, Dave Pantelis, Lou Forge, and Marty Lyman. Summer plans for the band include an assault on the Boston, Providence, and New York City areas. And let's take a look at Ephesus.
How is the band playing? What do you think? What are you feeling about your role and how things have been?
Before and after.
Well, I think in a lot of ways we've all matured in life in general, in realizing about priorities and our dedication and different circumstances that arise and how we have to deal with them as they come.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we respect each other's boundaries in a lot more than we did back then.
Okay.
Thank you.
almost one. The drummer is the most recent addition.
Yeah,
yeah.
You're
close.
Not the same thing. About 2 weeks earlier.
And I know you came from another local band here. What's it like joining these guys?
I get to play more bass again. The band I was in formerly was Juan and Pat, and like just being back on after that, I do hear that subconsciously, but here I actually get to play, so I like it a lot better.
And you're a keyboard.
Yeah.
So.
I try.
Yeah. And has it, are you happy joining these guys?
Yes,
is it a comfortable relationship?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why am I?
Information on Ephesus, please call 508-752-5175. Our next band, Three Believers, consists of Paul Farron, Brad Blackwood, and Mark Lannon. Writing and playing their own style of music for approximately 5 years, Three Believers have headlined at such clubs as The Channel, The Rat, Bunratty, Grover's, Ralph, Sir Morgan's Cove, and many other notable venues. Here are Three Believers. Do you guys want to introduce yourself?
Sure, I'm Paul Fern from Tree Believers.
I'm Brad Blackwood, and there's one more of us that isn't here. Mark Lannon, who plays the drums, and he's out of town on a personal matter.
Ooh.
But he gave us personal permission to be here anyway.
Oh, hey, what a nice guy. What a nice guy. We are from...
Worcester.
So you playing clubs a lot?
A lot.
B Club in Worcester. Have you done any work in Boston? You get to go back that far?
Yeah, we played in Boston. We played quite a few clubs there. Last year or so, we've just really worked our butts off in Boston and went through that whole thing.
How'd that go?
It went well. I mean, everywhere we played, we did well, but didn't really like it too much.
Mm-hmm.
Not that we didn't like Boston. It was just hard to get into. Not get into Boston. It's easy to play there, but it's hard to be from Worcester and play in Boston because you're from Worcester.
Yeah, there tends to be almost an animosity towards the Worcester bands. Oh, I like that.
That's the first question everybody asks you is, where are you from?
Pluto, thanks. What type of music do you guys play? How do you see music? I know classification's hard, but people watching like to know where you stand.
Well, it's very melodic. Not hard rock, not mellow, but somewhere in the middle there.
No, oh, you won't put me to sleep on driving a 495?
Ooh, might. I'm sure some people would fall asleep. But.
Oh, I've heard the tape, and I've seen you guys live in Orlando.
Have you?
What about songwriting? Who does things for who makes the song to you?
Well, Paul and I write most of it. Pretty much 50-50 that way. If you write something, you show it to me, and back and forth like that. And there's another small percent that we all three write together. And just whatever, a piece of music that we're working on just kind of just exists all of a sudden and it becomes a good song. And that's... Lately, that's been the best music that we've done. Mm-hmm. Music that has just appeared out of nowhere.
What type of lyrical content? What
type of
things do you write about?
I tend to write about my life and the way I view the world, and it's almost spiritual in a way. It's my own beliefs and the things that I believe in. If you want to know about it, you can listen to the music. But I tend to pull that out of it because it seems like the only place you can find any originality, some place that you haven't, you're not copying somebody or you're not being like somebody else, something that you can actually be for real and not something that's been used at the same time, even though you might believe in the same thing someone else does, it's you. And I don't know what he writes about.
What do you write about?
I write mostly about things that have happened to me. I find when I'm writing a song, maybe the last big thing in my life that happened tends to be the subject of the song.
No fast cars, girls, and sex, and things like that?
Well, that all happened last month, so that'll probably be the next song.
Oh, come on.
We don't get
videos with, girls with no clothes on, things like that,
No, I think there's enough of that already.
The Red City was a piece of music that Paul and I were working on, and all three of us got together and just, in my opinion, one of the best pieces of music we ever wrote that came out. I mean, I don't know what the case is going to sound like, but when that thing gets recorded in the real studio, it's going to be great. I heard that the tape really came out well, though. The video shoot that you guys did. We haven't seen it yet. But the song itself, The Red City, is, it's almost like a symbolism of your heart and love and how Esther, I'll tell you exactly the truth.
Why don't you just do that?
Yeah, just tell me the truth. Just get it out.
Is that a little red light on the camera?
2 minutes or less. Yeah.
Right there.
One night we were practicing and we shut all the lights off. He has hundreds of effects. Is it lights? And the whole room just looked like a red city. you know, with like a little city, like you were on a mountain or something, looking over there, and there was some building, skyscraper, and all the lights were red, except for a couple green ones. And,
two.
Two green ones. And, I started out, I was going to write about the Red City, what music and everything means to us, and how we express ourselves, and it ended up being something even more, you know, a progress to, you know, our music is an expression of our beliefs and our love for whatever, for other people and God and just life. And the Red City is something that everyone should build for themselves. And it's just your Red City. It's your love. And my Red City lights flood the sky with love.
Let's not get into that.
The first song I think that you're going to see is called The Red City. And the second song is called I Was Always There For You.
If you would like more information on Three Believers, please call area code 508-829-2588. If you liked either Ephesus or Three Believers, please go out and support them in the clubs. And back in April, Naturally Wired AP did some taping backstage at the Boston Music Awards. The awards were held at the Wang Center. Here are a few interview clips.
Oh, that's right. You mentioned that. Smile.
They are smiling.
So, how's your EP doing?
Yep.
It's doing great. Indian Sunrise is up for another award later on tonight. The EP itself is up for Album of the Year on an independent label. And
Song
of the Year, Indian Sunrise.
I mentioned, yes.
And this was the Rock Band of the Year, and we're just feeling great. Feeling high as a kite, I guess so.
Well, that's great. Now, what independent label are you on?
Black Rose Records.
Black Rose Records.
Black Rose Records?
Yeah.
Great.
This is great. We're really riding a huge wave right now. It feels wonderful. We've got a lot of attention. We're in the studio right now, and we're going to be going to Nashville to be in the studio with Barry Beckett. And hopefully we'll get some interest from some big record companies out of this. So we'll see. We'll see if we can't do